Welcome back to my channel. It's summer again. I remember doing my first year recap in this exact same spot, but it's been a long year. Thank you for sticking with me, by the way. It definitely felt like a long time, and I'm not gonna lie, last semester, it has to be my worst semester so far. But it's all over now, and I took my well-deserved break, so I'm feeling great right now. As you may or may not know, the entire DVM program is 4 years in total. And given that I have just finished second year, I am officially half of it. I definitely don't feel like half of it because I kind of don't remember anything I studied. So it'll be interesting when I get to my clinical rotations, but that's a future problem. And in today's video, you are gonna travel back in time with me to the beginning of second year. I hope you enjoy it. Let's go. Lectures were online, which I barely went at the scheduled time, except for the first lectures, because professors usually go through the syllabus with us in the first few lectures and give us time for questions. So that's what you're seeing here.
More basic behavior techniques demonstrate knowledge of a fundamental principle.
First year versus what was second year. So we tried to give you guys a bit more.
I rarely listen to lectures while doing other stuff because I take very detailed notes in class. So I need my full attention to do that. It helps me understand and retain the materials better. But this was my first lecture in the semester. So it's okay because I'm not memorizing the syllabus.
Do you have questions for me?
Oh yeah, I remember this. I had a question here, and I asked if our course handouts cover everything on the OSCE, which is our clinical lab exam.
So the question is, do the handouts cover everything tested in the OSCE? Yes, the goal is that the questions on the OSCE come directly from the lab handout.
Okay, this question did not just came from nowhere, because back in our first year when we had our first OSCE, I am 100% sure there were questions on the exam that we never learned or read about. So I always like to confirm with the professor on the scope of the exam. I mean, it doesn't hurt to do that. So that's what it was like in my first week. But for the most part, you would probably find me studying like this.
Enlarged, it's pretty much all of the gland appear to be enlarged.
This
point out are the ligament of the tail of the epididymis and the proper ligament.
Or this.
The lymphatic system is very hard to evaluate. It's a bit small that it's done.
And if I do find myself, you know, unable to concentrate in the class, I just take the break I need. I usually don't have a problem going back to study.
Sure, calf with an umbilical abscess. You can have an abscess form externally. You can see a little bit of swelling under the near the actual ventrum of this animal.
We have 4 to 5 classes usually scheduled for a day, and I do 4 on weekdays and catch up on the rest on weekends. I kind of touched on this in my midterm video. I said that the second year is kind of the most memorization heavy year, and most of the materials are pretty dry. And I would still agree with what I said. But in the second semester of second year, we started learning more things that made me feel more like an actual vet. You know, first year was all about learning how the body works normally. The macroanatomy, microanatomy, physiology, immunology, and a little bit of pathology. And even in the first semester of our second year, we were still mostly learning about the basics, but it was more medicine than biology. You know, we learned pharmacology, learning about the drugs, how they work, what species you can use or cannot use. We had bacteriology, mycology, virology, you know, studies of bacteria, fungi, and viruses. And we did more pathology. We talked about disease of different body systems and how to make diagnosis based on anatomical changes. We also had a year-long course on diagnostic imaging, reading radiographs, and it's actually super helpful in practice. I never knew you can get so much out of radiographs. So the second semester was more exciting, but at the same time, more challenging. I think it has to do with that the courses are much more clinical than academic. And for someone like me, who spent my whole life in academia and barely had any clinical experience, I find myself sometimes blindly memorizing things out of context. Say, we're in a surgery class, and the doctor is talking about the different types of suture. And we need to know if a particular type of suture can be absorbed. Is it slow absorption or rapid absorption? Is it monofilament or multifilament? They're all important information. And I can probably cram that into my head for an exam. But for me, I need to see the actual suture and feel the difference myself. And I want to know what it's like using them on different body layers or organs. But things like that are not taught in class. I'm supposed to get that kind of experience by working in an actual clinic. And I know that I don't do it enough. So I kind of just have to tell myself to suck it up and find ways to catch up on my own. So we don't get to choose what to take until third year. All the second year courses are still built in as part of the requirement of the DVM curriculum. I have listed here our 10 courses in the fall term and 12 in the winter term. Sounds like a lot, right? Because it is a lot. And like people say, it doesn't get easier. You just get used to it. So as you can see, in the winter term, we started having classes like surgery, anesthesiology, dentistry, nutrition, animal behaviors. And I know some of the other course names may not be that self-explanatory. So the medicine course is about the common diseases and clinical signs we see in practice. Say if a dog comes in throwing up, how do we know if the dog is vomiting or regurgitating, or if the dog has dysphagia, which means it cannot swallow? These different signs point to different parts of the body. And in this course, we learn the clinical approach to a patient, how to identify these signs and what to do next. Basically frontline clinical practice. And then there are two pathology courses. Clinical pathology is about making diagnosis based on the lab analysis of body fluids, like a complete blood count, which is the CBC report they always talk about, a biochemistry report, urinalysis, blood gas. Clinical pathology evaluates the patient based on numbers, which is the interpretation of lab results, while systemic pathology is anatomical pathology based on different body systems. You look at something with your bare eyes or under the microscope and make diagnoses based on what it looks like. Like the problem can be congenital, developmental, it can be trauma or infection, or it can be a tumor. In anatomical pathology, we learn how these abnormalities develop and how to recognize them from Bruch's lesions and histological changes. It's a really cool course. The tricky part with veterinary medicine is that we have to learn so many animal species, and they're all prone to different conditions. Something I learned in vet school that blew my mind is that you can get so much information just from the signalment of your patient. So in veterinary medicine, signalment means the species, breed, age, and sex of the animal, including whether or not the animal is neutered or intact. And a lot of the times, the veterinarian is able to generate a list of the possible problems just based on the signalment of the patient. Say if we have a patient comes in for bloating. If it's a large breed dog, right off the bat you would have GDV, which is a twisted stomach on your list of differentials, because they're prone to the condition. But if it is a cow, you would probably put pasture bloat high on the list, which is gas accumulation in the stomach from having too much high quality feed. You see how different it can be. It's amazing. And this is a very straightforward example. In reality, the species differences can be much more subtle. And you can only imagine how much information vets have to keep in their brains. It's just incredible. Fortunately, we still had our in-person labs. The labs were really the highlight of last year. I mean, I was always kind of confused in labs, but I did have a lot of fun.
She has style. She has grace. She is
messy. Yeah, definitely having fun in the ultrasound lab. So we were given this imaging phantom. It's like a gel mold, and we're trying to recreate an image of what looks like a blood vessel. Super fun lab. Ooh, this one's even better. This is our first tooth extraction, and we were working with real cadavers. It gotta be one of my favorite labs. So in order to do the tooth extraction, we have to lift the mucosal flap, elevate the periodontal ligament, and cut into the root of the tooth with a drill. It was such a glorious moment when we get to finally extract the tooth.
Okay.
There you go, squeeze tight and twist. Ready?
Yeah, twist. And twist. Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Because you did most of the work with the elevator?
Yeah.
I had a lot of firsts with my group last year. We anesthetized our first patient together. We had our first neurologic exam, and we had a bandaging lab. But instead of putting bandage on a real patient, we put it on my arm. And I think we were wrapping it too tight because my fingertips were turning blue by the end of the lab. We did so many cool things last semester. I love my group. This is us in the teaching OR. Like, everyone in my group is so nice, and I honestly couldn't have done it without them. I remember for the final exam, we had less than a day to study for the exam that was 80% of the course. And our group ended up splitting up the material into five parts because there are five of us. And then we each study a part and teach it to the others. It worked like a charm. It's so amazing to have a group that you know you can count on in vet school. I really appreciate them. I feel like I'm really lucky to be in this group. I guess that sums up my second year of vet school. There were a few interesting extracurricular activities that I was involved in, but I may put them in a future video. Most of what I do is related to wildlife. So yeah, I hope you like this video. Comment, subscribe if you want to see more, and you can always follow me on Instagram. It's mostly me and my dogs, but I don't know, my dogs are super cute, so check it out. You can also message me if you have a question. And see ya!